Coming up on News Radio KLBJ
748.
Lacey is calling from Riverside. Hi, Lacey. Welcome. Lucy. You're on KLBJ.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, Lucy.
Good morning.
I just wanted to say, while workers out there and people like you that are preaching morality at people like me living on welfare, can you really blame us? I mean, I get to sit home. I get to go visit my friends all day. I even get to smoke weed. Me and people that I know that are illegal immigrants that don't contribute to society, we still going to get paid. Our check's going to come in the mail every month, and it's going to be on time, and we get subsidized housing. We even get presents delivered for our kids for Christmas. Why should I work? So you know what? Y'all get the benefit of, saying, oh, look at me, I'm a better person. But when y'all send back talking about how y'all a better person because y'all go to work, we're the ones getting paid. So can you really blame us?
Are you talking on an Obama phone as well?
How much do you...
Yeah, I got an Obama phone.
How much have you added up the total of what you get each month, Lucy?
No, I haven't.
But you, what do you get? Just quickly go down the list of the things you get from the taxpayers.
Well, I only have to pay $50 a month for rent.
Mm-hmm.
And it's supposed to be $600 or something. So there's $550 right there.
Yes.
I get $425 a month for food stamps. I get $150 a month paid on my electric bill. I get my cell phone. And then I get $100 a month paid towards my water.
And that's from the city of Austin?
Yes.
Do you have any kids, Lucy?
I have 3 kids.
And does your husband work?
He'll work every now and then part-time, but he doesn't work very much.
Does he
just doesn't really see the need for it.
Does he get benefits as well?
Yeah.
So that
those are family benefits.
Those are family benefits. And Lucy is asking everyone listening right now, why should she get up and drive in the rain to work all day and pay taxes when she can get this kind of help from those of you going to work?
You know, and I do have a question for you, Lucy. Now, from time to time, if you have an opportunity and somebody pays you cash, do you work?
I have a couple of times, yeah.
Sure.
Lucy, don't you feel guilty about gaming the system and taking everybody else's money just because you can lay down and watch TV on Riverside Drive every dang day of the year?
Smoke weed.
But you know, if somebody offered you $1 million, would you walk away from it? I mean, it's easy to preach morality, and it's the only reason why I called. It's easy to say, well, yeah, you know, you're making your living off of other people's backs. But, you know, if somebody gave you $1 million and said, here, you ain't got to work for it, no strings attached, here, just take it. Do whatever you want to do with it. You would take it, too.
Mm-hmm. Lucy.
Okay, so they're not giving me $1 million out of my pocket up front, but over my lifetime, how much money is that going to be? And I don't have to work for it.
So you don't.
That's what I'm saying. Y'all can preach about morality, but the system's there. It's available. And people like me, at least I'm an American citizen. What about all these people that are illegal immigrants who don't do anything at all? And they just come here and they even work and they make money and they you go down to the WIC office, and that's the other thing, you know, WIC.
Yeah.
Over 80% of those people are not even American citizens.
How about
we give them
about
welfare, and then they can go to college for free.
Lucy,
can't even go to college for free.
Lucy, hang on a second. How old are you, ma'am?
I'm 32.
And you, it sounds as though you intend to stay on welfare your entire life, if possible.
Yes.
The rest of your life.
Yeah.
Were your mom and dad on welfare, Lucy?
Yeah, they did.
They were on welfare, too?
That kind of makes sense.
Do you want your 3 children to live on welfare when they grow up?
You know, I really don't know. I mean, if they want to work, that's fine. But, I mean, I wouldn't mind if they worked. I mean,
that kind of makes me stupid.
As long as they can get a really good job, something they were happy with.
But don't you look at me. I get up and work every day at my age. I'm kind of stupid then. You know, because I'm making all that money.
Lucy, Sam gets up at 2:30 every morning and drives in here to work.
Yeah. So
see,
I guess I'm dumb.
To do that.
Hmm? Yeah,
that's
I choose.
The price he pays for for being able to say, look at me, I'm a good person.
But the government says
it's not about choices. It's not that it makes him bad or me bad. It's just he chooses because he has that, you know, the thing about look at me, I'm a good person, I go to work. And I'm on the opposite end. I see myself as a good person. I don't do anything wrong. I don't do anything hurt anybody.
You don't think it's doing anything wrong by taking all... Lucy, you don't think it's wrong by taking money from the city and the state and the federal government, other people's tax money that we put into the system, and you're taking it every month to the tune of $1,300 a month? You get about $1,300 a month.
Well, if somebody gave you $1 million, would you take it?
I earn my money, Lucy.
I see your point. I see your point, and we're the ones that are the saps, and it needs to stop. Now, if your money was cut off, would you get up and go to work?
Yeah, if it was cut off, I would have to.
Well, I think that's what needs to happen, because we're dumb. See, the government puts a gun to my head and with a promise of imprisonment if I don't pay taxes. Does anybody put a gun to your head to take that money? Nope.
And if you find that guy who's going to give us $1 million, call us. Tell us. Yeah, tell that guy to call me.
You know, Lucy, I do appreciate your honesty. I really do.
Yeah.
How many people?
That's my whole point. If I was in a position where I had to work, I mean, that might be a different story. But not only do I not have to work, they're always, when you're in these programs, they're always coming to you and offering you more programs. And a lot of times, shoot, they'll even pay you to go to these programs. You know, hey, we'll give you some money, we'll give you this, we'll give you that. You know, and so they encourage you to stay on the programs. And then if you do try to get off of them, they penalize you anyway. Well, if you go out and you make $10, they're going to deduct $20 for you making that $10. So you really can't get off of it. And then, like, say someone like me wants to go to work. Well, then if I went to work, every dime I would make would go to child care anyway, so why work?
Oh, man, Lucy.
Well, it's a vicious circle.
Lucy.
It's a vicious circle. I certainly understand.
It's not a vicious circle, Sam.
It is, Ed. It's because we have a government that gives Lucy everything she needs, and because they want your vote, don't they, Lucy?
All right.
Yep.
All right.
Lucy, you
if that doesn't make your head spin,
get
out
a better
of control,
example for your children, Lucy, please. We need that in our society.
All right. 7:55 now at KLBJ. You can get in here and join us as well. 512-836-0590.